Hi, and welcome back to another episode of College Debt. Let's go. Throughout the history of cinema, there have been many ways to shoot a character on screen. You can shoot them in wide, or you can shoot them close up. You can shoot them head on, profile, behind, or whatever. The differences in how the character is shot in relation to the lens reveals a lot about the character and how the character lives in relation to the world.
Like how close-ups can indicate a closer subjectivity,
or how a wide shot can be an entire extension to a character's loneliness.
The decisions that the director decides upon in shooting these characters can really set the tone for how the audience will interpret their characters and everything else. So let's take a look with how one specific director decides to shoot her characters. Let's talk a little bit about Naoko Yamada.
Today's video is on two things, Listen to Blue Bird and a limited perspective. In Yamada's world, character perspective is defined by the frame. Almost every shot is defined by the presence of eyes, or lack thereof. Yamada has created a very interesting way of dealing with character perspective that relies on less rather than more. So let's explore why this works. How do you tell a story with just a frame and a pair of eyes? The first thing you should do is to give your character some space, and don't go in for a close-up unless absolutely necessary. It's typical to go for a close-up whenever you want to create emphasis on an emotion or action. Not that it's bad, but you can lose a lot of the significance of the shot by using it too often and for different reasons. So take the opposite. Don't be afraid to stage your characters in depth and away from the center or thirds. A composition like this is often used for comedic effect, since it's a quick way of showing the punchline without breaking the setup of the joke.
You want a staff job and you want a staff job. Anybody care about what I want?
I do.
Shut up. Get out.
But the effect is different if you use it for drama. Let's take this other example. It's the same composition, but it feels very different.
I can't work. I can't concentrate. I have no confidence. She does not fit in this house.
I think it's kind of ironic. If you look in Spider-Man, Hoffman is placed back here because he gets ignored. Depth staging emphasizes the foreground perspective, and all of this happens within a few seconds. But the effect is opposite in this shot. Even though the shallow depth emphasizes his perspective, the subject of the scene is actually on her. And once you see that there's a juxtaposition between depth and subject that don't match, you see the trick question that the director is putting here. These characters obviously matter to the story, but we're not given the chance to care about them. Let's take Nozomi for example. For Nozomi, this is obvious why. She's not operating in the same wavelength as Mizore, so they're always staged separately through depth and position. So imagine a halfway line. There are two cuts here where Nozomi passes to the other side. You'd think that this is the start of some relationship, and the movie even applies it here. But no, this cut only ends up reinforcing the fact that these girls aren't in sync. Contrast this with this pair who are staged together in the same half of the frame. You can maximize this disconnect by removing the eyes entirely. It's a particular quirk of Yamada's to insert lower body shots, because this takes away from us the ability to read their faces, which adds to the mystery of these characters. In other words, Yamada's creating suspense. If Alfred Hitchcock achieves the suspense by putting the important plot points to the center of the frame, then Yamada's doing the opposite. What seems to be important to the story is shown with the framing away from the subject. But I think that's the trick. She leaves us with the bare minimum, giving us information to fill out the surface, but nothing really beyond the characters themselves. The suspense isn't created from something physical. Like most personal interactions, a lot of awkwardness comes from the inability to infer. But you can't just leave your characters in the dark. You'll have to unravel the story and by extension, the character's emotions. Yamada's answer to that is the profile shot, which brings me to number two. I think Yamada thinks that the profile shot is like the halfway point between being emotionally clear and clouded. There's something to show, but there's also something to hide. Her use of the profile shot is also dependent on where the characters look in relation to the frame. Specifically, she does this through two contrasting profile shots. One where the character looks into the frame, and one where the character looks off screen.
Nozomi-senpai ga jibun ni awasete kureru to omotte nai kara.
Kousaka!
It's not very often that you see multiple people talking within the same shot, but because the characters themselves are isolated, it can lead to some very interesting cinematic ideas. Let me give you an example. Suppose you want to build an intimate connection between your characters. You can have them look into the frame, and at each other. But what about the opposite? For example, if you wanted to show emotional obscurity, then looking off screen can do the trick. The whole idea behind this is even while these characters might be talking with each other, they're literally and figuratively not on the same page. All in all, Yamada follows a simple but profound visual style in exploring the human psyche. Her images don't explicitly express anything, and I think that's why the style works so well. But I think that begs the question, why does she try to hide, through her characters, so much information from the audience? Let's see why with one more example. We begin with a two-shot, but like most of Yamada's establishing shots, it's always an ostensible indicator to what's going on. She does this by diverting our attention away from their eyes. But the conversation moves on. She takes the pamphlet and we cut to this single of her in profile, looking into the frame. Look familiar? But once this is revealed, she's now looking off screen. But as the scene builds, we see less of her face, and now more of her face. This is what makes the scene great, when one character tries to break the halfway line. The other character only reinforces that divide more. I think this goes to the core of the Yamada style and the limited perspective. Emotions are a crude, incalculable thing. When you're watching her movies, you only see half of the story, whether it's through their face or through the staging. Her style is to treat the camera as an extension to the character's feelings. And that's why you never see these characters at their fullest. But at some point, the story must reach its end. And when the thin veil falls, if we're going to make our characters feel human, then we should treat them as such. Let them breathe on their own. Thanks for watching.
ありがとう、みぞれ。ありがとう。